Please stop. Okay. Calm down. Yes, you're right. It is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity, but calm down, everyone. Barn, chill, man. Chill. Chill out. Just relax. Hey! Hey, before we play, there's a couple people that want to say some shit. I'm going to pass it up to someone. So, hold on. It's either Chris, Zach, or Sean. Fucking don't... Oh.
I got anything other to say than,
Shut the fuck up!
Shut up. Levi looked harder, faster, and better than anyone here.
Next. Hey, shut the fuck up.
Hey!
These past 2 months have been nothing but terrors and pain for me. I can't even begin to explain the impact of Levi had on my life. His brother doesn't even do it. It was more than that. And then every day, ever since we met each other, we were always hanging out and all of our life plans we were gonna do together. And the reason that this band's important is because we met each other at this show that they played in the basement. And then there was a record release show where we really realized we were best friends. And if he was here today, he would want you all to fucking mosh as hard as you fucking can. And for most of you who walk out of here, you guys are gonna go back to your normal lives, because this isn't what you do 24/7. Levi did this 24/7, and that's why he was one of a kind.
Some of you may know me, some of you may not. My name is Sean. I'm actually Levi's older brother. On behalf of myself, my family, and all of Levi's closest friends, all I can say is thank you. Like, thank you so much for coming out and just supporting and going nuts for one of the most wonderful moments I've ever met in my life. I mean, not a day goes by that I don't mourn my little brother's loss. And just seeing everybody out here going nuts and just tearing it up for him, like, he would be so stoked right now. I can't even put into words, like, this is the best way to honor his memory. And let's just go nuts, get loose, get ill, let's do some fucking stage dives, high fives, let's tear this place to pieces for Levi. This is what he's doing. Thank you again, all of you. I love you all. We're cool for that, for Levi Tom. Yeah.
Oh, good one. So,
we're iffy on dark days, but we can win it.
We're doing it.
Okay, we'll do it.
So, like most of you guys, most of you people here, I attended my good friend Levi's wake, and it didn't do anything for me. And then I went to the funeral, and it fucking infuriated me, because I was told that one of my best friends ever basically had died for nothing. And I was told that I was heartless and apathetic because I didn't accept something I was unwilling to believe in. Not only just to see him again, just because I had to, because that was the better part. Excuse me if I fucking suck at this. But the 3 or 4 hours I spent with all of you idiots has been better than anything in the last 2 months. I think everyone here has said it wasn't even just a friend that died. They said it was family, and to me it was more than that even. And this fucking scene that is a lot of times just based on pure negativity and just a sense of helplessness. He was truly every fucking day an inspiration. He, like Chris said, this was him 24/7. This is his fucking life. He took what he learned here and took it out in the real fucking world. And I hope that, you know, besides the fucking stomach full of delicious vegan goods and the fucking posters and the shirts, if you walk away with anything else, it's a desire to fucking make a difference, because that's what he would have wanted. I have one more real quick thing to say. I just have some thank yous alphabetically, because I don't want to give anybody priority here. You guys all did a fucking great job. Allison, Chris, Raven, Tommy, and Zach, you guys really fucking killed it while I was away. Every fucking band that played tonight, Razor Fade, even though they were late, Quick Clean, Headshot, Pucoid Scabs Gun, Kulo, No Class, Guinea Kid, and of course myself. Especially. Thank you everyone who made treats. Nathan for doing the flyer, and Harrison for screen printing them and then dying at home. He's throwing up blood. Okay, that's it. We're gonna have to play a few more songs. This one we've never played live before. It's one of the last songs we ever wrote. Oh boy. Here we go. Here's a clip. Well, don't stay in your fucking place. Fucking do something. Next song. Hey, y'all, this is a really big build-up for one fucking song. Let's do this.